Srila Prabhupada wrote that book, Who is Crazy? Anyone who's trying to enjoy in this material world is rejecting the bliss of the soul, the bliss of Vaikuntha. It's crazy. And people suffer, but still they will not give it up. Essentially, people are attached to suffering with the hope that some little pleasure will come in between. It's worth it. So everyone in this world is looking for benedictions, because everyone's more or less, sooner or later, desperate. Some people approach politicians for benedictions, some academic scholars for benedictions. Please teach me to be a scholar. Some for some physical benefit, they want some benediction. Here we find that all benedictions that anyone could want could be achieved by attentively hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. Extraordinary merit, wealth, fame, longevity, and all the objects of one's desire. On the field of battle, it promotes the strength of one's vital organs and organs of action. This is very interesting. You can get all these things just by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. But it's a trick. The trick is promise anything, but you won't get these things unless you hear attentively with eagerness. If you're not attentive and eager, you won't get any of this. You'll probably just fall asleep. You'll get some extra sleep. Because what you get, what you put into something, that's in material life as well as spiritual life. So one can get all these material benedictions if one absorbs oneself with one pointed attention in eagerly hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. It is a fact. However, while you're doing it, something else happens. You start losing all your desires for everything. And by the time all those desires are fulfilled, you don't want them anymore, if you continue hearing. The problem is if you just hear very eagerly, very intensely, and then your desires start being fulfilled, and then you get distracted. You think, actually, I'm very empowered. My life is better than it's ever been. I was basically just nothing before I became a devotee. And just see what hearing a Srimad Bhagavatam has done for me. Now I'm intelligent, people respect me, and now people give me, I have all kinds of nice facilities to enjoy. And then we stop reading Srimad Bhagavatam. Then what happens? Because you stop reading it, but you've already attracted the mercy of Krishna. Krishna won't let you go. He will not allow you to be content with that material life. Somehow or other, he'll bring you back to taking shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam in this life or the next, through the agencies of his multifarious energies. We have seen people come to Krishna consciousness, sincerely chant the holy names, hear Srimad Bhagavatam. They get extraordinary merit, wealth, fame, longevity. The objects of their desires are being fulfilled. But then the very benedictions of the Bhagavatam divert their attention away from the Bhagavatam. And they enjoy all of these benedictions for some time. But then they suffer. Then they get smashed. And then ultimately they come back to the Srimad Bhagavatam looking for something else. However, if we just consistently are eager to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, we lose the desire for all these things. Because that's practically what every page of Srimad Bhagavatam is telling us. We read about Hiranyaksha in this chapter. The benediction is given. He was very, very, he had all these things. But he was a miserable creature and ultimately died a glorious death at the hands of the Lord. Throughout Srimad Bhagavatam, we read about how nothing can satisfy the soul except pure devotional service. So Krishna is so expert, he promises you anything, and then he gives you what you really want. There are many stories. There is the story that Srila Prabhupada told about that thief. He wanted so much riches. For a thief to get very, very valuable riches without much endeavor, the ultimate perfection of life. Well, somehow or other, while he was looking for someone to rob, he came upon some sages who were discussing Srimad Bhagavatam. And these sages, they didn't have anything to steal. They were just living in the forest. They had their kopans and their little water pots. What do you get from a Babaji or a sadhu? But he heard them describing the beauty of Krishna, how he's just a little child, and he has a Shamsundar complexion, very beautiful, dark-colored form. And he has exquisite lotus-like eyes and beautiful, shining, curling hair. His eyebrows are like the bows of Cupid. And his mother, before he goes out to herd the cows in the forests and pastures, she puts on him beautiful jewels made of gold and silver, diamonds, emeralds, rubies, pearls. This is very, very interesting. He's alone in the forest. He's only a little child, and he has all this jewels on. I must find him. He kept listening that this child lives in Vrindavan, near the banks of Jamuna. He didn't want to forget this description, so he started going to Vrindavan with great eagerness. He was eagerly repeating their message in the mind constantly. It's like if someone gives you directions. If you don't have somewhere to write it down, you're constantly thinking, trying to keep it in your mind. So he was thinking, Krishna is his name, Krishna, 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 Krishna. He has lotus eyes, he's Shyam Sundar. These types of jewels in the forests of Vrindavan. This was constantly going through his heart. He was so eager. He was anticipating. If we could only be so eager, if you could be that eager to come and see Radha Gopinath, then what would you see? You would actually see Radha Gopinath. There are so many levels of how we can see Shri Radha Gopinath. The cockroaches are also seeing Radha Gopinath. But they have no conception that this is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They'll go on the altar and pass stool right there without even thinking twice. They don't think it's an aparad. Would you ever consider doing such a thing? So there's so many levels of how we see the deities according to our consciousness. In relation to how eager we are, Krishna reveals the spiritual nature of his own form. So this thief was very, very eager. All for the wrong purpose. He was trying to get ultimately all the things we're reading about here. Extraordinary merit, wealth, fame, longevity, and all the objects of one's desire. Because in this material world, the illusion is that money will give us all these things. People are very, very eager for money. Prahlad Maharaj said, for materialistic people, money is, it is like honey, very sweet. You can't eat it, but still that illusion is that it's so sweet because it can get me so many things. And through those things, I can become famous. It can give me long life. All my desires will be fulfilled. So this person had all the wrong reasons for remembering Krishna. However, he was so intensely determined to keep his consciousness fixed on Krishna. Om apavitra pavitro va sarvavastam gatopi va yasmarit pundarikaksam sabhayabhyantara suchi. We chant this upon initiation for very good reason, because the purpose of initiation in spiritual life is only one thing, purification. And there's only one way to purify our heart, and that's to constantly remember Krishna. Purified or unpurified, or even having passed through all various situations in life, one who remembers the lotus-eyed Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, Pundarikaksham, he becomes purified within and without. This thief was immersed in remembering Krishna.
You were listening to Radhanath Swami on thesacredconnect.com.